Welcome to another episode of Astral Auto Repairs. Can you dig it? Alright, guys and girls, check this out. Today, we just got the new camshaft positioning sensor for the 97 Mercedes E320. You guys and girls have been helping out a lot. Latest, we had no signal coming from the cam sensor. So today, what I'm going to do is show you how to change it. Also, we got two frayed wires that we're going to show you how to repair those with some solderless connectors, all right? So I'm going to grab some solderless connectors, grab the tool to do it, got a new sensor, let me get the tools to do it, and cross our fingers and hope this car starts. We'll be right back. All right. Now remember, we got two frayed wires here from the last time we saw, so we're going to fix those also. First, we're going to do is let's unplug this and squeeze this little clip right here. Unplug the cam sensor. Let's tuck our wires to the side. And you got two hex bolts that's holding the sensor in. They're 5mm. The bottom one, I couldn't even get to last time with a ratchet on. So what I got here is a 5mm quarter inch drive socket. Put it in like that. And we had left it loose last time. So we're just gonna unscrew that, being very careful not to drop the bolt. Okay, then we're going to reach down here to the bottom one. And it looks like this clamp is in the way. So let's tighten it up a little bit just to get our socket back out of there. This one out of the way. And let's try to get up in there and take it out by hand. Again, being very careful not to drop it, because if it looks down there, it'll look like it'll drop and I'll never find it. Okay, we got that one out. Now let's wiggle our sensor back and forth and pull it right out. You know, from the looks of the sensor, you know, it's not a good sign, because I don't see no cracks in it or nothing. Everything looks good. But, hey, we're getting a bad signal, so. Alright, here's our new cam sensor. We could have got this cam sensor a lot sooner by ordering it from Fisher or something. But, the sensors are kind of expensive on this car, so we just went ahead and went on eBay. And it took a while, you can see from the last video, to get this thing. Now let's open this up. Okay, there we go. Now I'm gonna match them up, make sure they look the same. Look identical, the same. Actually, if I had known about it, I'd say this one was changed at one time. Okay, it looks identical. Alright. And you see, now there's a little oil comes out of here. So I'm gonna take my finger, take a little oil out, just gonna put a little bit around the O-ring. Then we're gonna take our sensor, we're gonna put the sensor in there, and we're gonna do is twist it back and forth as we pop it back in. All right, now we got our sensor in. The easiest thing to do right now, let's get our upper bolt. Let's get that thread started. Okay, now take your time and do the bottom one, because remember, if it drops, that's it. Okay. Alright, then we're going to get our socket. And what we're gonna do here, we got a quarter inch drive wrench, and we're gonna use the wrench to grab onto the bit to tighten these up. First, I'm gonna tighten up by hand, and I'm gonna take my wrench. I'm
tighten that up. All right, let's reach down here to the bottom one. And the bottom one looks like it's going to be a little bit more difficult, so I might do a different plan on the bottom one. See if I can... Okay, this guy is just going to take a... Just going to go back and forth and turn it. Oops. Okay. That's in there. All
right, now, what we got here now, yes, these are computer wires are pretty skinny. So you want to use the red solderless connectors. It's a very easy tool to use. What we're going to do here, let's get this, make sure we got enough harness here. All right, let's start with the yellow one. What we're going to do is take some wire cutters. I'm going to cut this, cut that just like that. Now, if these wires were the same colors, you do not want to do what I'm about to do. All right, I'm going to cut both of them at the same time, but they're different colors, so. Okay. Let's start off with over here, since these are the easiest ones to get to. Then you want to make sure you have yourself a little couple pair of wire strippers. This is a cheap set you can get from any kind of auto parts store, hardware store, anything. They got more expensive ones also, but these have last through the years. They got automatic ones that got springs types. You put the wire in, you go click it, and it just snips it. But I had those, and they do wear out after a while. So what you want to do is just find out which one is the right size. Peel it off just like that. You want to twist that. Make sure it's tight. Oh, and let me get something right back. All right, now what we're gonna do here, let's do all four ends. Two. And this one's a little difficult to get to. So what we're gonna do here, pull up this little cover, put it to the side, just so we can get up on this, get this harness up a little bit. Three. And number four. Oops. And let me go a little bit more on that one. Okay, let's twist all our ends up. So when we squeeze them, this becomes a nice, tight. All right, and we'll be right back. All right, now what you want to do, you want to make sure each of those is about a quarter of an inch in length. Because you want to make sure it doesn't, too short and not too long. And if you're not sure, just take them all and you want to match them up. This one's just a tad bit too long. I'll just cut off a little tip of that. Check the other ones. Alright, just cut off a tad bit of this one. Alright. Make sure they're twisted up nice. Now you want to make sure that, because when you go ahead and put these in these connectors and squeeze them together, it makes a nice tight fit. Now on the end of your tool, you're going to see red, blue, and yellow. That's a very good indication to let you know where this connector is going to be at. Now if you look inside of this solder's connector, you see down in there, you see a metal clip. That's a metal ring. That metal ring goes from one side, like a metal tooth, right there, till about right there. Now what I like to do is, I like to put the tool right there at the
right at the end of that, where it's supposed to be at. At the beginning, right at the beginning of that metal tube. And match it up with red. And I keep it right there. Now what I'm going to do is take one of the wires. I'm going to push the wire in there till it can't go no more. And then I'm going to squeeze the pliers. So I'm going to make an indentation on it. If you can see inside there, what it did was squeeze that wire right in there. Nice tight fit. Alright. So what I'm going to do is grab my next one. Line it up. Go to my other wire. Push that till it stops. You don't got to force it. Just you'll feel it. It'll just stop. And squeeze. Make sure that's nice and tight. You know, hold it for a few seconds. Then let it go. Look inside. It's perfect. Now, next thing we're going to do is grab it from the other side. Now, before we do this side, I'm going to show you something here now. Because we spliced the wires off, that means this part right there is now thinner than the wire part. So when you put this wire in there, the sheathing on the outside, that's what's going to hit the outside of that metal tube right there. It's going to hit right there and stop. So you can't go no more. So don't force it in there, because you'll force it in there and then you'll crimp right around here, and it's going to be no connection. You'll be wondering why the car don't start or something. All right. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to line this up again and match the color of the wires. Put this one in there. Squeeze it together. Hold it for a few seconds. Make sure it's nice and tight. Let it go. That's one done. Let's go over here to our other one. Line it up. Get our wire. Crimp it and then hold it. Okay, done. This one is not bad, just a little pinch right there. But we're gonna do something. I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do with that. All right, now, because you got like this, you're not done. Because now you still got open wire here, and eventually if water gets in there, it's gonna be corrosion. Now what you wanna do is, before you do this, if you wanna use heat shrink, you can put it up there and it'll heat and it'll shrink the rubber tube up there, and it'll cause an airtight seal. Or what you can do, take our gloves off, because it can't work with this and electrical tape. If you don't have that, what you're going to do is take some electrical tape. You want to start back from the wire. Matter of fact, let's just take a piece off here. Start back from the wire. It ain't got to look pretty. You want to slowly wrap it around and squeeze in. Make sure it's nice and airtight. Go down to the other end and wrap it around the wire. That's so, you know, now you got the moisture won't get in there and everything is good. Just like that. All right, I'm going to put a little bit on the other one. Then I'm going to wrap a little tape around this little opening area right there. And we'll be right back. All right, we got that done. And what we're going to try to do here, now all of it might not fit in there. We're going to try to get it back into this protective housing. And you're going to have to work with that, especially where we got those connectors at. And to make it easier for you, what you want to do is, that red wire, that yellow wire is going to give me a hard time. I'm going to take a piece of tape, get the yellow wire in there. Do is keep going forward. Let's get that other one in there now.
I like doing this because it's like an added protection to it.
And it looks like, well, it's supposed to go all the way up there, but let's find out. Cut a little bit of this off right here. Okay. Now we got that. Now we're gonna do is I'm gonna take the tape. Go and seal that up. Now if you want, you know there's an opening right here. And I mean, you're pretty much good, but I just want to be on the safe side. You definitely want to try to keep moisture out of there. All right, there you go. Nice professional job. Let's turn our harness. Plug it back up, snaps into place. All right, let's get our shield back up here. All right, now what we're gonna do is, I'm gonna take the camera and what I'm gonna have Sylvia do is turn the key off, put the key on, put the key off. You know, we're gonna do that for about 3 or 4 times, because remember we siphoned out the old gas in there, try to get that gas, that fuel up here to the injectors, to the lines. And then what we also gotta do is over here. Matter of fact, let me do that now. Get a screwdriver. You know, let's make sure this thing can start up. All right, we'll be right back. All right, we got a freshly charged battery here. Now we gotta clean up this thing, man.
All right, so what I want you to do is put the key in the on position till all the lights on the dashboard come on, shut the key off, and do that about 3 or 4 times.
You just heard the fuel pump and the fuel system activate, and cross our fingers.
All right, crank it up. Oh, there we go. Look at that car start.
That was kind of rough, but this car hasn't ran in almost a year's time. Now, not bad, Not bad for 119,000 miles. I hear a little hesitation there and all. You know, but again, we don't know nothing about the car. Don't know how it ran before. So the only thing we can do is run it. See what kind of codes come up. But this was definitely a problem. Now, according to the Vantage Pro though, the cam sensor acts as a secondary reference for cranking. So that's going to mean that we got a bad crank. I mean, according to the Vantage. So we definitely going to go order us a new crank sensor and put one in there. All right, let's get the screwdriver and tighten that computer box cover down. All right, we'll be right back. All right, there you have it. Everything came out good. The only issue I'm having with this is, according to the Snap-on Vantage, now you guys and girls seen this, according to the Snap-on Vantage, the crank sensor will control that. And once the crank sensor goes bad, the cam sensor picks up. We did get a signal from the crankshaft positioning sensor. We did get nothing from the cam sensor. So theoretically speaking, we got a bad crank sensor also. We're gonna change that. But we wanna thank you for all your help. Greatly appreciate it. This is Timmy from Astral Auto Repairs. If we can't repair it, nobody can. Take it easy.